everything that RJ was teaching me years before about Jesus Christ, about the fact that he took my nature. See, as a Catholic, we were taught that Christ is so far away from you that you can't go to him, that you need Mary and you need all the saints to help intercede for you. But what I started to learn as I started to read my Bible is who Jesus really was, that the gift that God gave us, that the gift that God gave in his Son, Jesus Christ, was that Christ took my humanity, fallen as it is, so that in his victorious life, I could take his righteousness, and that God can look at me not as a sinner, not as somebody that's so messed up inside, but as pure and holy and righteous.
Amen.
And that it's not just a fairy tale, but that God will come into my heart and make that a reality. And that, brothers and sisters, is what I know to be the truth today. Is there victory in Jesus?
Amen.
The answer to that is yes. How do I know? Because I'm living proof of it. If you were to know me the way this man here knew me back in the day, and where I'm at now, is there victory in Jesus?
Amen.
Amen. Closing hymn this morning is hymn number 34.
Still his mic and pulpit. Yeah.
Excuse me. Before we do the closing hymn, there was something I asked to do earlier. Pastor, this is his last sermon. And I thought that it would be a good idea if the elders in the church came forward with his family and would pray for him. If we can do that. Ricky and Chuck, and we can come forward, and if his family could come up here, we just want to pray for him.
What about the rest of us? We'd
yes.
like to pray for him too.
I'd like for everyone to please stand. And if we can just kind of gather around, just pray for him, for his family. The love of God is truly in this place. And one of the things that he said during his sermon, which is apropos to everything that Christ is about, the greatest love and the greatest joy is to be able to allow the love of God to flow from you and be duplicated in other people.
Amen.
And if he's done that, then he's done what he came here to do. And so in gratitude and in thanks, we want to ask the Lord to bless him, to keep him in the protection of his bosom, to protect his family, and to know that we are always family. Once you're in this family, you're never out of it. So if we could just, you can come up to the altar and we can just gather around to pray for him.